In this video, we want to show some of the blending techniques and materials that we use. There are correct ways to blend, and there are ways that you can get you in trouble. People can overblend and create a tonal mess of things, and blending can't be done right. Blending is just a tool that you can have in your art style or tricks that you can use to make things look realistic. And when done correctly, you can get more interesting textures. You can get softer values. You can create more realism. We use blending techniques because it makes our artwork pop better. It made things look more realistic. And if you understand how to use the tools, there's no reason not to use the tools. Alright, so we will be using 8B Staedtler pencil because it has a darker shade and it is beautiful to blend. And I think this is a perfect pencil to use in this vlog. Okay, so let's start.
Sitting here all alone on a throne in a palace that I happen to own. Bring me some pheasant, Cupid on the bone. Fill my goblet up to the brim, sipping on mead, and I spill it on my dress with the gold lace trim. Not very prim and proper, can't make me.
You may not be familiar with some blending tools, so I'll start by showing
makeup eyeshadow foam. This is usually used by makeup artists.
Brush. And we have this synthetic brush, and we're using this to make our drawing realistic and smooth. Tissue paper. The third tool is the ordinary tissue or a toilet paper, and we mostly use them in background of our artwork. Blending stamp. We have this paper stamp of size 6, and we're using blending stamp for a detailed part of drawing. Cotton buds. This is a cotton bud, also known as a Q-tip, and we also use cotton buds tool for blending. Fingertip. You must be thinking that I'm joking, but actually, we are self-taught artists and we started drawing a few years ago. We was unaware of these tools, so I used my finger for blending. Anyways, let's compare all these tools by blending some shades.
The first one is a makeup eyeshadow foam, and it is used to blend eyeshadow. That's why I used this idea to use also in blending. To be honest, I didn't see yet an artist using this eyeshadow blending foam. It is because it is just an artistic idea that came from our mind, and it is effective in using this object in a detailed part of a drawing to create realistic and smooth values.
Thank you.
here, we have a sub-synthetic watercolor brush. Let's move on to dry brush technique. I already cleaned this dry brush with tissue paper, so don't worry about the color. It's a permanent color of this brush. I hope you can see the difference between the shades clearly. As you can see, we got some stain-like texture in this shade. And the reason behind that the blending stump always requires some pressure against the paper to work efficiently and to blend the shades. Where the brush doesn't require any pressure on the tip and you can use it the way you want, you can even blend the graphite powder more efficiently with the brush.
Tissues work great for light or mid-tones, but they don't work as well for dark, because much of your graphite will transfer to the tissue, making those darker values almost impossible to achieve. Here are a few ways you can use tissue paper to blend. Wrap a tissue around your finger, making sure to sponge the tissue at the top, so you don't accidentally smudge other parts of your drawing. Make a tissue ball and wrap it inside another tissue. This is similar to one above, except you can blend a larger area.
Blending stamps are one of the most common planning tools used by an artist. They are sticks made of tightly compressed paper with two pointed heads. Blending stumps are excellent tools to blend areas in smaller parts as to provide precision and good detailing. Smooth transition, smudging, smearing, and creating patterns are one of the functions of blending stumps. Tips. Number 1. Always use clean side to blend lighter values in order to avoid extra added value. Number 2. Use less pressure. Number 3. Soften the tip area. And always remember, you must not overblend.
Now, take a piece of cotton wool and rolling with your hands to make a cotton wool ball. Then wrap the cotton wool ball by a piece of soft tissue like circular candy which is wrapped by aluminum foil. Avoid touching the surface of the paper with your hands. Blend the graphite smooth using this tool.
If you want to try shading with your fingers, then I suggest do it on an experimental piece just to see what the result will be. Be careful if you touch a place on the paper that doesn't have any graphite on it. You could end up discovering a permanent fingerprint when you begin applying the medium you're drawing with. Try and blend out medium that has already been applied to the paper. Blend from the dark values out into the light values.
Like the cool blue light. These are the blending tools that we use to create smooth and detailed sketch, so that your sketch makes things realistic. You can do more things with more tools. You can get softer values, more interesting textures. You can create more realism.
So guys, I hope that you enjoy our tutorial vlog and you gain some knowledge and information that you can use if you are going to create a smooth and detailed sketch. Thank you!
Washed up, don't want you believe.